Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to my YouTube playlist on Node.js advanced training. So in previous videos we have already talked about the linting part, how to write the package.js configuration, and what are the different ways in which you can write the better apps. So continuing to the same track, we are now going to talk about the best practices for the Node.js app, writing Node.js app, and we will talk about the different aspects. So this is, in the previous videos we started writing one Node.js apps and we were including the packages and all. Before moving to that point, I wanted to cover few videos on what are the best practices for writing Node.js app. So we will follow a few points and we will talk on to those points. Maybe we will extend it and we will talk about that. So you write a Node.js app which is single threaded and no IO blocking, which is a Node.js. But while writing the application, what are the best practices which should follow so that our application is foolproof? Okay, writing the test cases, doing the proper deployment using PM2, providing the logging, providing the error handling, using a style guide, adding the ESLint to the applications, using the asynchronous code wherever is needed, using the promises or using async await or using the promise chaining, or require all the dependencies upfront, how to manage the configuration, how to manage the different environment like dev, QA or UAT or production, how to set up this npm rc, how to set up the ESLint rc, how to set up if you are using some database or some other applications, like you want to Redis, you want a MySQL, then how to do the complete setup with the Docker Compose we are going to use here, okay, and how to provide a security of your application using either token based authentications, or to if you are writing the web applications in Node.js, then how you can prevent this cross-site scripting attack using the Helmet, or how you can monitor the application either using New Relic or either using PM2 monitor, or handling the errors coming from the APIs, which can be 200 400 401 403 409, okay, and adding the script to the package.json so we can do everything in a single file, and using the environment variables, like using the process variables in Node.js to capture the environment, like process.env, mongodb url, process.env, node.env, all these things. And finally, testing your code with the help of supertest or with the help of mocha, or you can also write your automation test cases using the postman and run them using the newman. So postman is like, this is a rising module which I'm seeing, that you can write your integration test cases there in the postman scripts, and you can run them, and you can also calculate the code coverage using that. No need to write a super test test cases. Okay, there are multiple logging libraries, like Logily is there, or the most common library is a Winston logger is there, with the different transporters are there in the Winston library. You need to use the PM2 for deployment, because whenever your application gets stopped or there is some exception, it restart your application automatically. Okay, so all these things, this is the complete focus for me, which I will be covering in few videos, where we will talk about the best practices from getting started to the Node.js to the advanced. Then we will take the boilerplate and we will do the advanced stuff on that Node.js application.